Hello, it's me. It's Manding Lisa Sopery. Yes, it's me. Happy 2024. It's so funny because the last video that I published, I did a mistake for the year 2024, and I said, "Oh, why I said 2024 then? I don't know. It's a human mistake. I'm so sorry." So I said I'm going to apologize on my next video of what I said. For the mistake that I made, yeah, it's 2024. It's a human mistake. I'm so sorry. So for this video, I'm going to share this. I made these tools. I'm going to make my Valentine's soap with the heart, and I made this. Supposed to be I'm going to make embeds, but I said, well, that's too much work for me. I'm going to wait until the embeds gonna be hard enough to put in the other molder, so I decided to make my soap shaper. It's a heart, so it looks like this. This one, yeah, it's gonna look like this. So this is gonna be the top part of the soap. The top part. It's going to be like this, and this is the bottom of the heart. Yeah, it's like this. I cannot wait to see if my soap scraper or my soap shaper, it's gonna work with my design that I like. And I'm only going to use two kinds of oil for this soap that I'm going to make. I think this is the most important oils for soap making, the olive oil and coconut oil. Yes, I'm only going to use two oils, olive oil and coconut oil. According to the soap cup, this is this kind of soap is really good or great in cleansing, and I'm going to add additives to make this soap really nice soap. Yeah, so please bear with me. Let's make a soap now and let's see if this tool is gonna work with my design. Welcome to my channel of soap making. It's Manding Lisa. As always, there is a safety precaution of making soap. I'm always wearing gloves, goggles, and long sleeve in preparing my lye. There is no kids or pets are allowed to be around during you're preparing your lye or you're making your soap. That's a big no-no for cold process making. Thank you. As always, I'm using a strainer and pouring my lye into the mixture to avoid undissolved lye goes into my soap. This fragrance oil that I'm going to use, this is new release from my supplier, and I think there is no reviews yet, but I just want to try this. And this is a version of their Chanel 5, so let's try this. I don't know yet what's gonna be happen. But this one, it's getting more thicker now. I don't need to panic. I only need to mix it again to make it soft. And I think, yeah, this is still good. This is still working with me so well. I only need to scoop it into the molder. And I think this is the mixture that I need so I can scrape it nicely. The one reason why I use only two oils in making this soap is I just want to make still a good soap, even the oil is really pricey or getting expensive right now. I'm so excited if the soap shaper or scraper gonna works well. My new tools in soap making, my new soap cutter, I'm happy to have this. I'm showing that there is some holes in the soap, but that's not a big deal. It can be easy to fix. I'm going to show how I'm going to fix this later. It's really easy. I think the heart shaper did a good job. The heart is kind of cute and it's really visible that it looks like heart. And the bronze mica that I use for the heart veins, it looks like nice. But I think next time I'm going to put more sprinkles so it's really going to be visible on the other side. This is the tools that I'm going to use for fixing my soap if my soap there is some holes sometimes. It's very helpful tools for fixing your soap. So I fix everything. It looks like there's nothing happened with the soap. This is the good thing for the handmade soap. There is no perfection. And perfect makes the soap unique. This is only 2 days old soap and the lather is good. and the smell of the fragrance oil that I use, it's really good. Thank you for watching. I hope I inspired you again of making soap and creating your own tools for soap design. Bye! See you next time! Thank you to all my subscribers. It means a lot to me. From the bottom of my heart, thank you so very much. Sending you love.